Hi y'all. In today's video, I'm going to show you the 7 most common mistakes made with a propane fryer. Hi y'all, Don here with Southern Backyard Cooking. Today's video will showcase the 7 common mistakes made when using a propane fryer. Not doing these mistakes will not only make your frying experience enjoyable, but it will save you money and be a lot safer for you. Okay, so counting down from number 7, the 7th biggest mistake you can make is not turning the propane to the off position when you're finished. Don't just turn the valve off, turn the propane valve off. That'll make sure that no gas is going to your fryer anywhere. So mistake number 6 is lighting the burner with too much pressure. So first thing I'm going to do, I'm about to light it, is I'm going to turn my gas on, my propane on. I want to barely turn my gas up. Okay, I want to light my flame, put it in here, and then turn my gas up. And you can see it started. And I want to make sure it's done like this. I don't want a lot of pressure. Okay, once I get my flame lit here, I turn my red knob on my regulator up so I can have pressure and it starts heating. Okay, y'all, mistake number 5 is never cook with the lid down. It will build up pressure and heat in here so much more. All right, guys, mistake number 4 is not skimming any of the excess stuff that's floating around in your vat. You just want to skim it, let that skimmer drain. That keeps all the particles, the breading and everything, from getting down into the bottom, and that'll end up burning and giving your shortening an off taste. All right, mistake number 3 is when you're cooking anything, make sure that you're not cooking or dropping anything into that oil that has ice or an excess amount of liquid water on it. That will make the oil boil. And in a lot of cases, it will boil over and you end up burning somebody. All right, mistake number 2 is not filtering your oil. So you wanna make sure you get a filter, actual filter, and this is a filter funnel so that it will go right in. One of the things you want to make sure you do is you want to check your temperature. Make sure you're around 120 to 150 degrees, and then you can just empty the valve out in the back right into your gallon jug, your 4-gallon jug, and just filter all the crap out of it. Then you can clean it. One of the nice things about these fryers, if you can get a cover that goes over this, so that you don't have to empty and keep the oil out of here. You can leave it right in here. Oil is gonna be one of your biggest expenses. For a 4.5-gallon jug, it's gonna run you around $18, $19, up to $30. So you wanna make sure you can reuse this as much as possible. Filtering the oil, skimming the oil like I showed you, and keeping all those little particles. They burn and turn to carbon. That gives it an off flavor, an off taste, and you're gonna have to change your oil out more regularly. All right, the last thing and the most important thing is to regulate your temperature. I like cooking in the green. You do not wanna go into the red. I have had my fryer off now for about 8 minutes, and you can see I am still at about 340 degrees. I never got it above 365. Basically, once I get it around 350, I turn the flame, I turn it all the way down almost, but not put the flame out so I don't have to relight it. These Cajun fryers by RV Works are very forgiving. They maintain the heat. They are made of real thick steel, not stainless steel, out of steel, carbon steel, so they are very, very well built. All right, y'all, I hope you enjoyed my video about the mistakes that you can make on an outdoor propane fryer. Remember, these are for making it enjoyable to cook, but also the biggest one is being safe. You don't want to have something come up and have kids around when you're doing this, and you don't want to have 350 degree oil splashing on people. Oil burn is the worst burn you can possibly get. I hope y'all had fun. Hope you enjoyed my video. If you did, please make sure you like it, subscribe, ring that bell. Till next time, folks.